In other news, the Prime Ministers of both the Cook Islands and Tonga have had health scares in the last week, with both men requiring urgent medical attention.
In New York last Sunday, Tonga's Lord Tui Vakanoa suffered a mild stroke and had to be hospitalised, while Cook Islands Prime Minister Henry Puna flew to New Zealand as a precaution on the weekend after complaining of chest pains.
Let me just say, first of all, how grateful I am for all the prayers and the best wishes.
A PM recovering with family in Auckland. Henry Puna's had a hectic schedule in the last year. For example, he was in Auckland for the Polynesian leaders meeting at the end of August. So when he felt tightness in his chest, he sought urgent help.
I woke up with some chest pains last Sunday, and given the recent death of my best friend, Nevier Pati, on the golf course from a massive heart attack, I wasn't going to take any chances. So I basically checked myself up to the hospital, and the doctors did some tests and thought there was something wrong that needed further exploration here in New Zealand. And so they referred me down here in a hurry.
Puna says tests show he's in good health and should be back in Rarotonga early next week. But don't expect him to slow down in coming months. Rather, he says he'll make some lifestyle changes. He urges his people to do the same and to be mindful of their health.
Sometimes we're a bit shy, and so we leave it until it's too late. But I think the message that I'd like to get across to our people is, the moment you think that there are issues with your health, please do something about it.
Meanwhile, Tonga's Prime Minister, Lord Tui Vakanoa, seen here in Auckland earlier this year, is recovering well. He's been discharged from hospital and is expected back in Tonga later this week.
One of the smallest Pacific Islands groups in New Zealand is celebrating their 35th independence this week. The community is also holding the inaugural Tuvalu Language Week in New Zealand.
Activities have been running all week around the country to celebrate Te Ngana Tuvalu. We take a look at how strong the language is at a cultural day for one of Tuvalu's 8 islands.
Talofa.
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 Welcome.
Yes, talofa is hello in Tuvaluan. Say it with me, talofa.
Talofa.
Perfect. Well, most Tuvaluans live in West Auckland, and today one of the island's new tau is getting together in Ranui to celebrate their culture. Now, at Tuvalu celebrations, you must wear your headpiece or fall, usually made from leaves or flowers. Maybe plastic?
Okay.
Or you can improvise. It's a good chance for everyone to catch up. Today's celebration is all in the Tuvaluan language, and the highlight is definitely the traditional dancing, which is called Fatele.
The language is very important to me because that's where I come from, and I have to keep speaking my language.
Okay.
And I have to tell my kids as well.
Okay. How fluent are you in Tuvaluan?
I'm actually really fluent in Tuvaluan because my grandparents only speak Tuvaluan, they don't speak English.
For Tuvaluans living in Auckland, these kind of events are so important. When it can cost between $2,000 and $3,000 to return home, many families just don't. So these kind of events keep the culture and the language alive.
Being a small population here in New Zealand is also in danger. Unless the government of New Zealand is supporting us and especially supporting a program at preschool, secondary school, at that level.
And if you're feeling the whātele, tula ki lunga o mako.
Engari ki te pote ne kaya
ne kua tāwiri aro, kua usumi nai mātou whātele, I te inga nā rau whatūwai. Kua whaisoke nei mātou o sākanga. Ki mea rau kora ne māsani ai mātou, I tumatou o te whenua, kua saka mātou. I saka tumatou o te whenua tūwai.
E ngali tau saka malama. Stay watching after the break. We're in the Hawke's Bay for the Bay Safika Festival.
I am New Zealand born and I grow up knowing not much, that's for sure. And seeing everything from the performances and the food, it makes me complete as a person.
Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. In the Hawke's Bay, the Pacific communities are taking centre stage with the Bay Safika Festival.
As John Pulu discovers, it's a celebration of all things Pacific and shows the strength of this growing community.
Ah, Hawke's Bay, famous for being Art Deco capital of the world, with breathtaking scenery and home to some of New Zealand's award-winning wines. However, today, Pasifika people are the centre of attention.
Hawke's Bay has a growing population of Pacific Island people now, so hosting Bay Safika is like a home away from home event, not only for the locals, but also for our PIs that are migrating from all over the Pacific Islands. So the main concept of this event is educational and awareness.
Welcome to Bay Safika, a cultural celebration here in the Bay Area using Pacific dance, arts and crafts, food and music. Sitting in the front row is Blossom Sale, who's keen to learn more about her Samoan roots.
It's like connecting us with where our parents are from because I am New Zealand born and I grow up knowing not much, that's for sure, and seeing everything from the performances and the food, it makes me complete as a person and it brings me to a place where I naturally belong.
Lapa Stamatalangi feels right at home. She wants to keep her niwe and culture alive for the next generation.
What I would like to pass on is to try and learn and maintain the culture. But with my help, I'll try and teach them to do it. Monu, 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 tangaloa. So wake me up when it's all over,
when I'm wiser and I'm older. And while the action on stage is capturing the crowd, the local health providers are also doing their bit to connect with the community.
When you come to these sorts of activities, you start to build relationships with them, and they're face-to-face. In terms of difficulty of building a relationship with our community, you know, we all know our people are in churches, and these sorts of things brings them out and brings them all together across the board, and it brings the health services to the people. And once you say hello and form a relationship, you can take it from there.
It's a special bond that the organisers want to see grow beyond today's showcase.
We'd like to add in more activities next year, maybe get involved nationally, have some national groups attend just for that Pacific influence.
A Pacific influence that'll enrich the Hawke's Bay for years to come.
The smoke-free Pacifica Beats Grand Final was held at Epsom Girls Grammar over the weekend.
And with $30,000 worth of prizes to be won, the six finalists turned up ready to do battle. Soana Keahule was there.
They're playing to their own Pacific beat. The annual Smoke-Free Pacifica Beats gives young talent the chance to showcase their skills in both songwriting and performance. And with the quality that's on show tonight, it's hard to believe that these kids are still in high school. These six acts, Lupe, Hidden Tales, Ngahuia, Pure, Strangely Arousing and Revived Rhythm, are the regional winners from around the country They've come to Epsom Girls Grammar in Auckland to compete in the grand finale. And for some, the bright lights and big city are a world away from home.
So I take it there's not a big Pacific Island community where you are? Or
flops and cows and haddocks and milking sheds.
This song is about finding your culture.
It's originals that count in this competition, and for most of these bands, they've infused a little of their culture into the tracks.
Brown skin, brown eyes, curly hair, I can't disguise.
Our first song is called Pacifica, and that's about finding your home and your culture. It's a song that I wrote when a Tangaroa College, their choir, came to our school, and they're all Tongan, and I'm Tongan as well, but I'm not so involved in my Tongan culture, so it was real cool hanging out with them and just being immersed in, like, just, you know, the natural environment that, you know, I felt a connection to. So I wrote that song to kind of capture that moment for me. Politics, no baggy
shirts and no kids, yeah. I first wrote the lyrics when I was in class and I was watching a documentary on, like, Pacific Islands in it, and I was, like, really inspired, like, language, having the respect in traditional cultures, and yeah, just a lot of stuff that came to my heart and my mind.
Thanks to sponsors like APRA, the Health Promotion Agency, and Creative New Zealand, the prizes are worth $30,000. An extra bonus this year is the live online stream of the event, ensuring that none of the supporters miss out.
Yeah, we're trying live streaming since it's a smaller venue and a lot of our audience are nationwide from Temuka to Whangarei. So, yeah, we try and offer that service too. They all can't be here, but yeah, live streaming, it is really awesome.
The live stream also allowed the nationwide audience to see the big winner on the night.
We are too strangely arousing, all the way from Rotorua, taking it out, smoke-free Pacifica Beats 2013. You gotta love it, you gotta love it.
Well done to all the students. We might have a future lord right there. Well, it's Community Notices time, brought to you with the track Hold You by Vince Harder featuring Jay Williams and K1. For a minute I lost my head, my heart beat out of time. All I wanted to do was just stay here. Let the clock tick and just wait here for somebody to pull me out. Somehow your light shone bright and led the way. And I never imagined that this would happen to me. Been calling out, just waiting. Now I'm in the moment, just pacing. Yeah, you made me come alive.
Thank you, Navar, for helping us with the notices. Also, this Saturday is Pacifica Breast Cancer Awareness Annual Walk-In Breakfast. The walk starts at 7 a.m. at One Tree Hill in Auckland. For more details, just go to our website and click on Community Notices. When we come back, we're with one of Dunedin's Pacific pioneers.
That's where I come every week, every Monday, for line dancing.
Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika Tālofa. Tonight we pay homage to one of our Pacific pioneers from Dunedin. Mise Emakisha has lived there for almost 35 years.
The 73-year-old is a master weaver and is busier now than when she ran her own leather manufacturing business. Sandra Kailahi reports.
Mise Emakisha lives and breathes weaving.
On the last 2 days we make flowers and we make a mat, and we make two-corner purses.
Emma's finishing her 3-day basic weaving class in Dunedin. She's passing on the knowledge, igniting the passion in others.
I split it to about half an inch. That is a good way, not too narrow, just that width.
And her students can't get enough.
Actually, a lot of satisfaction from just being able to finish the whole thing. It's interesting going to a Samoan person who's got a slightly different take on things.
She's got heaps of knowledge and yeah, it's just really nice that she's wanting to share that with people in the community.
It's really cool, like
passing down her knowledge to me. She's really nice. I love my grandma.
And being able to pass on the craft to her granddaughter, Savannah, is a delight. Emma was around 9 when she started learning.
Also, can you sew white?
Mum used to stop me when I take over grandma's mat. She said, don't. The techniques won't be the same as grandma. When grandma go outside to have a smoke, I jump on the mat and sit on the mat and weave. But when grandma came back, she said, this girl's gonna be a good weaver. The techniques are good. And I think that word of encouragement, you know, stay with me.
The Kesha family moved from Invercargill to Dunedin around 35 years ago. Emma followed her husband Harry there for work and better opportunities for their 6 kids.
We love the people. We love the setting up of the city, and the university is the best university in the country. And we thought, we'll come up, you know, for the sake of our kids, they can do whatever they like in courses or study.
So Emma, this is South Dunedin. You spend
right.
a little bit of time down here.
That's right.
You talked about this place over here.
Yes, this place, South Dunedin Community Hall, is the old South Dunedin Town Hall. And now it's a community hall. And that's where I come every week, every Monday, for line dancing. To keep me fit.
Yes.
And so that my foot can remember where to go.
Nisa embraced life in the South. She even set up the Multicultural Weaver Society there. When she was made redundant, she used her payout to set up her own business, a small leather goods company. And she also sold some of her weaving, as well as Pacific clothes.
And pick up the next one, all in pairs.
18 years later, she retired. Well, sort of. Nisa travels here and overseas to teach weaving to others, like at the last South Pacific Arts Festival in the Solomon Islands.
There were a lot of them gather around our workshop, wanting to learn how to finish products from our way of weaving.
Emma is the first to admit she wouldn't be able to do it without the support of her husband Harry and her children.
What have you been up to?
I've been cutting flax for you.
Oh, good.
You should be here making a bowl too, dear.
Misa's using her daughter Jules' business to host the workshop, and her son and his wife help with the administration managerial side of Emma's weaving business.
All my brothers and sisters, we're really proud of our mother for what she has achieved. And she's worked really hard for it, and I suppose it's come to that part of her life where she needs to be looked after. She spends a lot of time looking after us, so I suppose it's our turn to look after her.
That's good. What are you going to put in there? Cell phone and your keys.
Emma's effort over the years is paying off. She was awarded a QSM in 2011, but in 2010, Misa won the Creative New Zealand Senior Artist of the Year Award. Not bad for the retired pioneer, who is now busier than when she was working, but she's always had time for her other love, Pacifica.
I grew up in the Pacific, in Samoa. I've seen committees of women, and I miss that. We never had anything like this. You know, our children go to school, and we do our housework and the garden, and we have nothing to belong to in the community. And come around the front between two pieces.
Emma turns 73 at the end of the year. She's got a full calendar until then. She recently returned from Samoa, where she was commissioned to teach women her weaving techniques. She loves it, and Emma is showing no signs of slowing down.
Thank you very much, ladies, for putting up with me. And it's nice to see the outcome of your hard work. It's always my passion, and as an artist, I would love to share the knowledge, God's given gift, the talent, so that I don't have to take it to the grave.
Isn't she beautiful, eh? Misa, thank you for that story and thank you for sharing your line dancing. Didn't know you were a line dancer as well, Sandra.
Amazing. Well, this week on Real Pacific, the team are in Aotearoa.
This is going to be fun.
It's Matariki now, so everything is in its full growth. Here we go. This is Pickle Pickle, or Fiddlehead Fern. There's over 312 different varieties, but only 7 are edible in Aotearoa.
Tastes like fresh green pea, like the tendrils.
Yeah.
Have you had it before?
No, definitely not. Māori people, when they first got to New Zealand, they had to do a lot of hunting to find what they could eat. So it's actually made me appreciate my heritage a lot more.
Right, here's one here, look.
Okay.
This is pukudo, which is a puffball.
It looks like a brain.
You want to go in and get that one for us?
Not exactly.
Don't fall over, Gil.
I'm going to try. Oh, my gosh.
Wow, he said it looked like a brain.
Well, if I saw that in the bush, I wouldn't be eating it. Let me tell you that.
Remember, you can catch all our stories and find out what's happening in the community online at tvnz.co.nz, keyword Tangata Pasifika. On Facebook, just like us. And we're on YouTube as well. Well, that's it from us for another week. Nisa mode.
Ke manuia de vai aso, to fa mua.